Okay, yeah, he's back to being numb again. What is this? Oh, some rocks with a rope set up? I'm at risk for hypothermia.
I've never felt so cold in my life.
Well, down I will go. Greetings, adventurers. Don here again, and I'm back with another session of The Long Dark. I'm going to continue where I left off last time, playing the very difficult bear challenge mode called The Hunted. This is part one of that, apparently. Now, after my last recording session, after I went to close the game or save the game, and the game crashed, and apparently my save game file got corrupted. So, I redid the first portion of this challenge, and I'm back to where I was, back to where I left off. Everything's pretty much the same, except for I might have a few different items, like, for example, some different clothes. Oh, I forgot to wear that down vest. I have no boots, so I'm in my stocking feet, my sock feet. So that should be cold. That should be cold. Blah, blah, blah. I can't talk today. But pretty much everything else is the same, about the same. Now, I think I've gotten everything out of this basement that I'm able to, but I am pretty much out of food and almost out of water. Let's drink that little bit of water, actually. Okay, so my water is almost gone. So I'm going to have to go back outside as much as it's nice and safe and cozy here in the basement. I'm going to have to go outside if I want to try to find new supplies, get more food and water, and try to make it to the destination where I'm supposed to travel to Trapper's Cabin in Mystery Lake. And I'm not even quite sure where the heck I am right now. So let's go outside and hope that that mad bear or vicious wolves aren't waiting to pounce on us. So first thing I do is look around. I don't see any bears or wolves immediately, but they could be lurking nearby. Oh, here's another new thing since the update. I think it's new. It's rosehip bushes. Now you can pick the rosehips. And apparently, I haven't done it yet, but I read on the message forums, if you get enough of them, something like 25 or 30 or so, and if you're at a campfire, you should be able to make like a rosehip tea, and that can help warm you up, maybe recover a few calories, and apparently it can also act as a type of painkiller too, I think if I read it properly. Anyways, it seems, feels like minus 25 Celsius, so I'm going to get cold rather quickly. And let's hope I can find some shelter soon. Oh, here is a deer. Okay, now I could cut off the meat, but it takes time. And as I'm harvesting the meat, I'm freezing. So I'm actually going to just set up a little campfire here. I'll use some reclaimed wood. And that way I can also cook the meat after too. So I'm going to start the fire. And also having the fire going will hopefully keep at bay any wolves or possibly the bear, because I don't think they like getting too close to the campfire, from what I've seen anyway. So come on, fire. Go, go, go. At least it's not too windy yet. Damn, that didn't work. It's not too windy, so at least I have a chance to get a campfire going here. If it's too windy, chances are you won't be able to start a campfire. Or if you did, it might blow up rather quickly. Now, I did play a little bit on my own after the last session. Played a little bit of the sandbox mode to become a bit familiar with some things since I've played it, and look around the locations a bit, become a little familiar. I mean, it's a huge sandbox now. It's a much bigger place to explore now compared to when I played it before, when I did the previous videos like a year or so ago. Okay, so we got the campfire going. As I'm doing that, okay, let's add in some more wood, a couple pieces of reclaimed wood, and that should keep us warm while we harvest some meat from the frozen deer carcass. Yeah. So that'll keep us warm. And now, let's cook that meat. Gamey venison, raw. Well, let's cook it. Sunset.
It's gonna get a lot colder soon.
Okay, so it's getting dark already. And, you know, I could try to get some hide and guts from the deer, but I won't at this point. Because, let's see, I'm just going to melt some snow into water. Maybe 1 liter worth. No, I won't get the hide or guts from the deer, because you can use that for crafting things later, but where I'm playing a challenge, I'm gonna be on the move quite a bit. And from what I understand, it takes 5 game days to air out and cure the hide and the guts so they become usable. And I don't want to be concerned about that right now in this particular challenge. I don't know if I'll even have time for that. Now, I'm just half wondering if I should risk just kind of sleeping out here. No, I mean, he's rested. He's chilled, but I'm not too cold now where I was next to the fire while I was cooking. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to risk moving on. And, actually, what I'm going to do, I forget if you could do this before, but one thing I noticed now, you can take a brand from the fire and you can use that to wave at wolves, maybe to keep them at bay and scare them off. I'm not sure if it quite works on bears, but it can also provide a little bit of light too. The only problem is it doesn't last too long. So let's look around. There's a stick. Now, like I mentioned, I think last time, you can break down the branches, but it takes time to do so. It goes quicker if you have a tool like a hatchet. But as you're doing that, you're freezing. Okay, I thought I heard some footsteps or something. I mean, you never know what it could be. Whoa, I'm up high, like on a cliff. Okay, I don't see a safe way down, so maybe it's better I just go back from the way I came. Maybe. Okay, this fire stick is pretty much burnt out, so I guess I'll just drop it and go back to my flare gun. Distress pistol, whatever you want to call it. Okay, there's the deer carcass.
Cold is making my head.
Oh no, the fire is already burnt out. And he's already getting quite cold. But we gotta move on. I gotta take a chance to keep moving. Now, I know I shouldn't be running too much because you get tired quickly, but I'm running because I don't want to be in this freezing cold longer than I have to. Okay, what's this over here? Is that the house that we were at with the basement? Or is that a different one? Or, I think it's a different one.
Too cold to think.
Skeeter's Ridge. Okay, there's a body. Frozen corpse. Oh, he had a fishing tackle. Cool. That will certainly come in handy. Maybe I can do some fishing. I found a flare. What's this? A metal box. Ooh, decent fleece sweater. Okay, so I need to find some shelter soon. Oh, crap. There's a wolf. I'm going to switch to my flare real quick. And if the wolf comes after me, I'll light the flare. And hopefully that'll scare him off. Oh, crap. He's coming after me. He's coming after me. Oh, I think I hear the bear as well. Okay, I'm going to climb up into this ledge. Light this flare. Oh boy, I'm in trouble. Climb up onto this rocky... Oh, there is the bear. Now, the flare's kind of noisy, so forgive me. But, boy, I am in trouble. There's the bear. Hopefully the flare will scare him away. And where I'm up on this rocky ledge, hopefully he will have difficulty getting to me. Okay, you bastard. Get lost. Get lost. Yeah. Well, I think what I'm going to do, because I'm freezing, maybe I'll try to light a campfire here, if possible. Okay, right there. Start fire. And hopefully the fire will scare away the bear. There he is. Oh, boy. Yeah, I think he got scared from the fire. He went running away, whining. Let's hope this fire... we'll go. It takes a little while to get going. Almost there. Come on, baby, light my fire. Yes. Okay. So I got over an hour of that on the fire. Okay, I'm going to drop this flare. Boy, it's noisy. Okay, let's drop that flare. And while I'm here, I'm going to boil some more, or melt some more snow into water. And then boil it. Okay. How much time do we get left on that? We have 1 hour left. Okay. Ooh. There's a blizzard that picked up. I didn't quite notice it. I'm a bit sheltered here behind this big rock that I'm at. Okay, so I guess I picked a good spot. Okay, the flare finally burnt out. Wow. I'm gonna have to risk moving on soon though, but I can wait here for a little while to warm up. In the meantime, let's see, he is ravenous and thirsty, so I'm gonna eat that deer meat that I cooked up. And that's the last bit of food that I had. And let's drink some water. Glug, glug, glug. Let's check on that fire. You know what? I'm going to make a little bit more water. Take advantage of the fire. While I'm doing that, he's warming up. Okay, and boil that. Now, I don't know if the bear's still lurking around. Maybe the blizzard might have made the bear take shelter as well. Let's see, he's a bit tired. Okay, I'm gonna throw on a couple pieces of reclaimed wood. Enough for 2 hours. And then I'm gonna see if I can actually set my sleeping bag and rest for 2 hours. Okay, take advantage of that fire being there. Get the warp bonus from it. Hopefully it won't blow out. And maybe it did. No? Okay, well it did blow out, but it was still kept me warm for a while I slept. Okay, so I don't see... I got one flare left. Let's take out the distress pistol again, the flare gun. Okay, well, I don't see the bear right away. I don't see the wolves. But I can't stay here too long because I will freeze quickly. Now, where the heck am I? I really don't know where I'm at. Okay, now, if you're going down like a really steep part, it's safer if you crouch. And if you sort of zigzag on an angle when you're going down like a really steep part. Otherwise, like if you run straight down a steep part, there's a chance you could hurt yourself, sprain an ankle or something. And spraining an ankle is not good. Stick. I will pick up the sticks. It's all good for fire. You can also use...
Can't feel my feet.
Yeah, I need to get a pair of boots or something. I'm still in my sock feet, so that's not good. Okay, yeah, he's back to being numb again. What is this? Oh, some rocks with a rope set up? I'm at risk for hypothermia.
I've never felt so cold in my life.
Well, down I will go. Okay, I'll grab hold of this rope. And we will climb down. And hopefully we will find some kind of shelter down here. I just hope that the bear's not down here waiting for us. Okay. Whew. Now, should I stay here or should I... Okay, I gotta kind of move on. Oh, there's a rabbit I just seen. But I don't have anything to catch it with. Okay, I gotta move on because... If I don't find some kind of food soon, I'll starve to death. But look at this. There is a little house or shack of some kind. Oh, definitely what I need. In we go. Oh, thank goodness. Now let's hope we can find some food or something in here. Backpack? Come on, give us some. Yes, an energy bar. Okay, it's better than nothing. Let's see. It's kind of dark. I can't see very good. There's a container on the shelf. Come on, come on. Nothing. Okay. Ooh, there's a bed. I can sleep in that and warm up for an hour or so. Empty crates. Okay, let's check the drawers of this dresser. Come on, I would love to find a pair of boots or something. Something for my feet. And, ooh, what is this? Another granola bar.
That'll come in handy.
Granola bar. Anything else? Just the shelf. Okay. I could actually break down the crate. Turn that into firewood. Let's see. But what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to end this session. First, I'm going to eat something. Eat that energy bar. So he's not starving. Drink some water. And then I will rest for a couple of hours. Few hours. And then move on. And I think I'll leave it there at that. Oh, I think I see something up here. What is that? Oh, it's a mug or something. I can't pick it up. Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Remember, if you have any questions for me, put them down below in the comments. Because I'm planning to do like a question answer Q&A session on an upcoming video for my 500 subscriber special. I'm almost there. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so, or tell your friends to check out my channel as well. Anyways, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. I appreciate that. Ooh, okay, so I'm going to finish this session. Stay safe, stay warm, and bye-bye for now.